Today, he was at Nebraska's other nuclear plant, the Cooper Nuclear Station near Brownville, which is also facing flooding concerns. That plant is operating at full capacity, and the chairman is checking Nebraska Public Power District's flood preparations. KETV News Watch 7's Andrew Ozaki joins us live on the phone with the latest. Andy?
Yes, Chairman Gregory Yasko got here probably about 3 o'clock. He's still on the tour, actually, going through the Cooper Nuclear Plant. They gave us quite a bit of access to the whole plant right now. And you can see that the levees are probably about 2.5 feet before they would actually have to go on alert and shut down their core. They still believe that they won't have to do that. They showed us the berms that they built up. They could actually go another 6 or more feet after that in order to protect all of the facilities that they have inside there. They showed us where the river is and how close that levee is to coming onto the property. They've got maybe about 25 yards before they actually start entering any buildings. But first, they have to cross a number of berms that they have built up. Now, even if the water does get into the plant, which they do not believe that will happen, they showed us how the dry storage, where all the spent fuel rods are stored, they're encapsulated, and they could handle under 50 feet of water for quite a length of time. So there's no concern about any types of leakage, radioactive leakage that might go into the river. Those are secure. The reactor itself is encased in a 6 inches of concrete and 3/4 inch of steel, and so as it keeps radiation in, it would also keep water out of that particular area as well. We've got a little bit of a chance to talk to the chairman about what his impressions were. He basically said he was not there for an inspection. They have nuclear regulatory people who have been on site and monitoring the situation. He's just there just to kind of get a feel for what's going on. He said that it appears they're doing all the preparation they can to mitigate any types of problems that may occur. But he was very noncommittal as to giving any type of signing off on if this plant was out of the clear or if it was going to be completely safe. Now, they have a number of backup systems. The big question, that they have to keep is backup power going to those nuclear cores if they shut this down to keep those rods cool. They showed us like 3 different diesel backup systems that they have in case they lose power to the plant, as well as a number of other contingencies that they have. Like I say, it was very impressive. They were, they tried to answer as many questions as we could. We were asking a number of things. Could this be like Tokyo Fukushima plant? They said no, absolutely not. They've had quite a bit of time to prepare for this, and hopefully all those preparations will pan out.
Andy Ozaki reporting live near Brownville, and we will continue to watch progress and updates from both nuclear stations throughout the evening. Thanks, Andy.